about these rules. Divisibility by 2. Now, if the last digit of a number is either 2, 4, 6, 8, 0, then the number is divisible by 2. Last digit means unit digit, this one. This is the last digit. This is the last. This one is known as last. Meaning of last is here, this one, unit digit. If the unit digit of a number is either 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then the given number is completely divisible by 2. The divisibility rule of 2 says this one. Now we'll examine whether the given numbers are divisible by 2 or not. See here, now we'll divide this one. 234 divided by 2. We'll see whether actually it is divisible or not. Now by 2. First we'll take 2 ones are 2. 2 minus 2, 0. We'll take next digit. 3. 2 ones are 2. 3 minus 2, 1. Take next one down. Now 2 sevens are 14. Now see here, we get remainder as 0. We see for remainder whether if we get remainder as 0, then the given number is 234 is completely divisible by 2. Otherwise, if we get remainder other than 0, then the number is not divisible by 2. We say the number is not divisible by 2. So here 234 is divisible by 2. Now we will take one example. Here last digit is 7. So last digit means unit digit is 7. It is an odd digit. If unit digit is even digit, see here, these are even digits, 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. If here a even digit is present, then the number is divisible completely. It is divisible by 2. Otherwise, if here last digit is 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, such odd digits are present here, then the number is not divisible by 2. That means we will get remainder other than 0. Now we will examine this one. 2 fours are 8. 8 minus 8 is 0. Take this one down. Now 2 fours are 8. 1 remains. This one we will take down. 2 eights are 16. 2 nines are 18 is greater than 17. So 2 eights are 16. Now we will get remainder as 1. So 897 is not divisible and 234 is divisible. This is remainder. This is divisible. Divisible. This is not divisible. Now we will check for these numbers. Divisibility rule of 2. We will check for 1078. Now take first digit or unit 10, 100. Already you have learned the division process. So we'll take this one. In 2 table 1 is not there, less than 1 also not there. We'll write 10 and take next digit. It becomes 10. 2 5s are 10 and we'll subtract. We'll take next digit down and write here 007 means 7. So 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 8 is greater, so 2 3s are 6, we will take and subtract, 1 remains, we will take next digit down, it becomes 18, 18 and 2 9s are 18, so we get remainder as 0, then it is known that 1078 is completely divisible by 2. Now we will see one not here. In similar way, we'll solve this one or this anyone. 102 divided by 2. In this way also, we can divide the number. It is the dividend, it is divisor. We'll write quotient here, we'll get remainder here. In 2 table 1 is not there, so keep 0, take next digit, it becomes 10, 2 5 is 10, 0 we get here, take it down, and 2 1 is 2. Here we got 0, so it is completely divisible. Now 2510, 2510 we divide by 2 and see what we will get. 2 1s are 2, 0, take this one down and write here 2, 2s are 4 and 1 remains. Now 2, it becomes 11, 2 5s are 10, once again we'll subtract, 1 remains, once again take 0 down and right here it becomes 10, 2 5s are 10. So we got remainder 0, then it is completely divisible. So in the similar way, you can write any number of digits, any number of digits, and you can check it out whether the given numbers are divisible by 2 or not. In this way, we will find whether the given number is divisible by 2 or not. We have to see here. This is unit digit we have to search. If it ends with 424680, then without doing any division, we can say that it is divisible by 2. Now we study divisibility rule of 3. What it says? It says, if the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3, then the number is completely divisible by 3. For example, 234, 315, 102. What is the meaning of this? If the sum of the digits of a number means what? If a number is given, for example, if 234 is given, we'll add the, how many digits are here? 2, 3, 4, 3 digits are there. Now, we'll add these digits. 2 plus 3 plus 4. It is the sum of the digits. So, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 4 is 9. Now, we'll divide. If the sum of the digits of a number, this is the sum of the digits of a number, is divisible by 3. We will see whether 9 is divisible by 3 or not. 3, 3 is 9. So it is divisible. So if sum of these digits are completely divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. Now we will check whether 234 is divisible by 3 or not. 234 divided by 3. Now 0, we'll write here, 0, we'll take this one, 23 is not there in 3 table, 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 3 7s are 21, we'll subtract, 2, 0, take this one down, now 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 24 is there, 3 8s are 24. See, this number is divisible. Without doing this division, we can easily understand that this number is divisible by 3 or not. Simply what we have to do means here we have to add these digits and we should observe whether it will come in 3 table or not, or it is divisible by 3 or not, we have to check. Then without doing any division, we can say that this number is divisible by 3. So here we will add this one. 3 plus 1, how much? 3 plus 1, we'll take this one, this number now, 315. We'll add these digits, 3 plus 1 plus 5. 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 5 is 9. Once again, sum of these digits is 9. So it is divisible, completely divisible. So this 315 is also divisible. Now we'll take this one. Check for 102. 102 we'll take and we'll add these three digits of the number 102. 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 2 is 3. So sum of these digits is 3, and 3 ones are 3. So this number is also, sum of this 102 is divisible by 3. Then these numbers are completely divisible by 3. So we'll take another number, for example 8 0 1 3. We'll add these digits, 8 plus 0 8, 8 plus 1 9, 9 plus 3 12. Now 8 0 1 3, we'll add these digits, 3. Now 8, this is 9, 12. Sum of these 4 digits is 12, and we'll divide 12 by 3. 3 fours are 12. So this number is 8013 is completely divisible by 3. We'll check it, whether it is really divisible or not, we'll check. See, 8 0 1 3 by 3. 3 twos are 6, 2 remains, take it down. 3 6 are 18. Here 2, this is 0, take it down. 3 7 are 21, and this is 0. Now take it. 3 ones are 3, and this is, we'll write here, 3 ones are 3. 3 minus 3, 0. So this is divisible. This is completely divisible. This is divisible. And these all numbers are divisible. We'll take another number. We'll take another number and see whether it is divisible or not. Now 5, 6, 1, 2. 5, 6, 1, 2. What is the sum of these digits? 5, 6, 1, 2. 5 plus 6, 11, this is plus 1, 12, this is 14. Sum of these digits are 14. Now we'll divide 14. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15 is greater. So 3 fours are 12, 2 remains. So this 5 6 1 2 is not divisible. By without doing any division, we can understand here that 5 6 1 2 is not divisible by 3. Now we'll check whether what we understood, the divisibility rule by 3, is working correctly or not. Now we'll check it out. 5 6 1 2 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3, 2 take it down, 6, 3 8s are 24. Now 2 take it down, 21. 3 7s are 21. Once again 0, take it down, 2. Now in 3 table 2 is not there, less than 2 is also not there. Write 10 and take next digit is not there. So this is the remainder. This is the question. So 5612 is not divisible by 3. We can understand without doing actual division only, we'll easily understand whether the given numbers are divisible by 3 or not.